First of all, I would like to thank the organizer for inviting me to part 4 to speak about accounts and importation in Istros. Do you see the PowerPoint?
Yeah, perfect, yeah.
Okay, thank you. Istros was founded in the 7th century BC, a few kilometers south of the Danube Delta. Excavation began here in 1914, leading to the discovery of several thousands of stamps. In 1957, a first catalog was published by Vasile Canalac and completed in 1986 by an article of Maria Koja. Alexandru Avram and Nicolae Konovici published the volume of the Istria series devoted to the Thasian stamps and the Sinopean stamps. After the death of Nicolae Konovici, Alexandru Avram worked on the publication of the Rhodian stamps in the same series. The other stamps are intended to be published by Alexandru Avram and myself in the same series, Istria. It is within this framework that I propose this contribution devoted to the Acanthian stamp found in Istros. I will first look back on what is known about the stamping of Acanthos, then I will highlight what new knowledge the Istrian lot bring us. Finally, I will reinsert it in the broader framework of importing Dobruja. The stamp of Acanthos have long been attributed to Thasus. The discovery of an amphora workshop in 1987-1989 at Acanthos allowed to attribute them to this city. The work carried out by Ivan Garland and Sergei Monakov gave a better knowledge of the production of Acanthos while being basing of the local discoveries. The workshops were in operation during the 5th and 4th century BC. The amphorae are very similar to those of Thasos and Mende, but their fabric differs. Costantinos Philis distinguishes, according to his workshop finding, 4 types of amphorae, 3 of which can be stamped. Thanks to new Pontic discovery, Sergei Monakov proposed a chronology of these amphorae. A stamp with the letter alpha can appear in relief in a circle on raw amphora under the 5th century. Rectangular stamps with abbreviated name or monograms, possibly accompanied by symbols, dolphin, torch, dated to the 4th century, appear to be quite rare. A third and better known category of stamps includes the so-called wheel stamp. They are mostly circular and divided into 3, 4, or 5 sectors. There are also some square or oblong variants with those sectors. According to Yvon Garland, these stamps contain 2 abbreviations: a personal name and a unit of measurement in volume, which corresponds to the approximated capacity of the amphora on which the stamp is applied. The capacity ranges from 3 cows to 1 meter, with 6 intermediate modules. The 20 names identified at this time are not arranged chronologically. Yvon Garland, after having opted for the name of magistrate, now considers that this letter corresponds to producer. Nevertheless, what might challenge some interpretation is the rarity of names beginning with Dame, three names for 4 people in the lexicon of Greek personal name, and Thor, three names for 4 men from the northern Black Sea dated to between the 1st and 3rd century AD. It seems that most of the amphorae are stamped on only one under with a wheel stamp. Sergei Monakov has published 4 stamped and amphorae with both unders preserved. One has a stamp on each under, while the other 3 have only 1 stamp. From the Boyanovo in Thrace comes an amphora with 2 stamps, a wheel stamp and a monograph stamp, alpha kappa, which could be an abbreviation of the Hetnis. The rarity of this stamp, about 20 present in the archive of Yvon Garland, compared to the wheel stamps, leads to think that it is rather the exception than the rule. They could date to the end of Acanthian stamping, since in the Boyanovo, the archaeological context with this stamp is from the end of the 4th century or the beginning of the 3rd century. The chronology of the wheel stamp is uncertain for the moment. Yvon Garland suggests the year 340-310 followed by Mikhail Ivanchenko, while Sergei Monakov suggested the 2nd and 3rd quarter of the 4th century for the wheel stamps. Yvon Garland notes that these stamps are absent from Olynthos, destroyed in 348, but they are associated with a filling around 330 of a public well in the northeast of the Agora of Thasos, Edvard at Amphipolis were also attested in archaeological context dated to after 330. The absence of wheel stamp in Castanicesma, where the bulk of the amphora in post up around 355, give another hint for the chronology. This would reinforce Yvon Garland's idea that the production of wheel stamp began after 350. In a pit in Andiman's Cove, in the Dniester estuary, a wheel stamp is associated with the stamp of Etimas, a late Iraqurat producer, who is traditionally dated to after 310. But Sergei Monakov dated this producer to the 340s. These different elements agree in dating this stamp to the second half of the 4th century. Although it is difficult to be more precise. The batch of amphora stamped from Istros include 24 wheel stamps and two other attributed more or less certainly to Acanthus. A part has already been published by Vasily Kanarake and Maya Koja, 11 wheel stamps and two other stamps. According to the archive, Yvon Garland had the opportunity to observe a number of unpublished ones from Istria, which he probably included in the count he published in 2014. The stamp alpha lambda, what you can see, seems more like a monogram than just the two letters alpha and lambda. These letters are systematic glued together and form a new on all these stamps. At this time, it's impossible to decide whether this is a variant of the wheel stamp system with a producer alf something or la something and the unit of measure of a metric of the first three letters of the personal names. On the stamps epsilon mu, there seems to be a desire to show the circle so characteristic of Acanthian stamps, even if the stamp is oblong. It could be an amphora containing one nitrite. Of the 20 known producer abbreviations, 12 are present in Istros in the wheel stamps. These include debris producers such alpha, theta, theta, omicron, p, omicron, and xi, epsilon. 8 of these are from producer xi, epsilon, id est 1/3 of the 24 known by Yvon Garland. This producer seems to know another representation in Istros, which could correspond to a one-time arrival of amphorae from this producer. The chronology of the Acanthian stamps is confirmed by 5 stamps found in the same context at Istros. In 3 cases out of 4, the 5 stamp is dated in the second half of the 4th century. The last context corresponds to a street for the realization of which various materials were used. The chronological indication is therefore not very convincing. The rim of 4 amphorae are preserved and are characteristic of Acanthus amphora in the shape of a triangle with notably a flat upper part. Only one is an exception as it's more rounded. One under was stamped 3 times with the matrix Karim without a clear explanation since the second impression is very legible as you can see on the picture. This reinforces the idea that the double stamping of amphora studied by Sergei Monakov is more an accident than the rule. This particular stamp, Karim, is probably to be read as an abbreviation of the name, Kari something, and of the matrix. Of the 21 amphorae on the wheel, whose module is identifiable, 10 are of 1 nitrate, about 35 liters, 10 of ficus, about 14 liters, 1 of 1 amphorae, probably 20 liters. There is nothing surprising in the absence of small amphorae because so few are stamped. 2% of the stamped Acanthian amphorae are of 4 coats or less. There is a relative balance between the two main types of continental Istros. In Karatis, where 45 wheel stamps had been found, the situation is quite similar, with 45% of the stamps with metret and 45% with 5 coats. A slightly different situation is found in most of the consumer center of the Western Black Sea. Tomis, as you can see, has only 7 stamps, but only one of 1 nitrate. but this can be a coincidence, which can play a big role in such a small sample. In Tubas, on the 44 wheel stamp published, 60% came from amphorae of 5 coasts. The two stamps from Albrecht are 5 coasts. On the contrary, in the Sungari settlement on the banks of the Dniester estuary, amphorae of 1 meter also dominate. In Odessos, located further south of the 15 wheel stamps, 71% correspond to amphorae of 1 meter. In Messambria and Apollonia, for which few stamps are published, as you can see, the Acanthian stamps are almost absent, and so we can say nothing. Along the Western Black Sea, there are 143 known legible stamps, from which 59 are 1 of 1 meter, and 66 of 5 coasts. It's a different situation from the one that Yvon Garland highlighted for the North Aegean, since the large amphorae of 1 meter represent 58% of the amphorae, followed by those of 5 coasts, up to 27%. There are those of 1 meter which dominate the export, between 60 and 70% of the findings in Amphipolis, Thasos, Arunkomotimi, and in Ainos. For exports, on a regional scale, the further away from Acanthos the amphorae are discovered, the less important the share of amphorae of 1 meter is. Several hypotheses can explain this distribution. The merchant would have preferred first to sell the most voluminous amphorae and thus the most cumbersome, but also those which make it possible to compensate more quickly for their expenses and to release cash quickly to make purchases on the way for the personal need of the merchant or for his commercial interest. The smallest amphorae are also the easiest to store with others as a complement to the cargo. Now, in the third quarter of the 4th century, the Aegean amphorae often encountered in the Black Sea are Phasian amphorae whose modules for this period are rather small, with volume between 6 liters and 12 liters, and quite close to Acanthian amphorae of 5 coasts. The consumer center closer to Acanthos studied by Yvon Garland could have benefited from state delivery from Acanthos, which would explain the important proportion of amphorae of 1 meter. One can also observe that the further one moves away from Acanthos, the more the proportion of amphorae of 1 meter decreases compared to those of 5 stamps. It is at 14:1 for Amphipolis, but at 2:1 for Ainos. The case of the Black Sea would be only the extension of this situation. There seems to be a south-north gradient as the share of Acanthian amphorae decreases from south to north. This south-north gradient is also observable on the scale of the Black Sea, since the presence of these stamps in a region as remote as the Asian Bosphorus is very limited. The proportion of Acanthian stamps is not negligible for the southern centers, since they represent between 14 and 22% of the finding at Kalatis, whereas in Tomis their presence is very limited. At Istros, less than 4% of the stamp and material for the second half of the 4th century came from Acanthos. This testified to a supply which was blocked thanks to coastal navigation. It thus seems that the stamp and Acanthian amphorae circulated in the Black Sea as a secondary cargo via networks of traders who circulated specifically between the Aegean and the Western Black Sea and were probably distributed by cabotage trade. This would explain both the smaller share of Acanthian amphorae in the northwestern Black Sea compared to southern Dobruja, as well as the predominant presence of medium-sized module of 5 coasts rather than large amphorae. Thank you for your attention.
Great, thank you very much, Thibaut.